First woman of color to win statewide office in Virginia will be sworn in as lieutenant governor this weekend. Before making history, Sears was in Hampton Roads visiting one of the state's most historic landmarks. Alex Littlehales is live from Hampton with more on Sears' visit to Fort Monroe. Alex.
Yeah, David, since November, some of Virginia's next elected leaders, like Governor-elect Glenn Youngkin, have come forward about what their administration is going to do and what they hope to achieve moving forward. But for Lieutenant Governor-elect Winsome Sears, she's only appeared publicly a couple of times since the November election, so we were able to actually catch up with her today about what she hopes to accomplish as she is part of a new political landscape here in Virginia.
Thank you. Walking in the footsteps of history, Monday, Lieutenant Governor-elect Winsome Sears visited Fort Monroe, the site where the first enslaved Africans landed in English North America in 1619. Sears, a Republican, named education as one of her main focuses.
And I'm going to say it again, education lifted my father out of poverty.
And at a site with ties to slavery, she says not every lesson learned here is necessarily an ugly one.
It's all three. There is good, bad, and ugly in it.
Well, the concept of critical race theory is not taught in Virginia schools. Sears has stated on the record she wants it out of classrooms. CRT is a concept that evaluates systems of racism and challenges people to make a change. Sears says CRT is a negative perspective of African American history.
I don't subscribe to the victim, you know, hood that some people would like to put on us as black people. We have survived and thrived. We have overcome.
Sears says she's focusing on working for everyone, even the Virginians who didn't vote for her.
I am now the lieutenant governor of my former opponent. And when she calls me and asks to see redress from her government, I must answer her.
Sears will officially be sworn in this Saturday, 3 days after the next General Assembly convenes this Wednesday. In Hampton, I'm Alex Littlehales for 13 News Now.